Supporters poured onto the pitch but were ordered onto the terracing before play was allowed to start. Once underway, Hibs dominated the first quarter, but it was Rangers who scored first. Russell broke down the right, swung the ball over to Cooper, whose cross fell perfectly for Ali McCoist. Early in the second half, Rangers scored again. Russell crossed to Durant, whose flick beat keeper Ruff to find McPherson. 2 minutes later, persistence from Bobby Williamson paid off. Out with a broken leg last season, he celebrated a complete recovery with a tenacious third goal for Rangers. Hibs were down but not yet out. With half an hour left, they pulled one back when McBride's cross was fumbled by keeper Walker but converted by substitute Dury. So, a 3-1 win for Rangers to put them top of the Premier League and leave Hibs without a point.
Since the magnificent Ibrox Stadium boasted a Scottish Championship-winning side. The full house at Ibrox is a splendid sight. And after Rangers' best start to a season for a decade, the crowds are flocking back. 28,000 for the match with Aberdeen, 35,000 for a stormy affair last Saturday against Hearts. And manager Jock Wallace is the first to emphasise the significance to Scottish football of a successful Rangers team.
I think the term new firm was created by Fergie and Jim McLean to get the press up that way, but there's no way in the world can they get the same kind of fans as us, the same amount of fans as us. It just doesn't happen. You know, when Rangers and Celtic are playing well, we'll take the crowds, but we'll take the travelling crowds as well, which is more important as far as the provisional clubs are concerned. We had 35,000 here last week, and if we beat Celtic on Saturday, we'll be here again next week against St Mirren. As far as I'm concerned, you've never lived or died in football until you've been beaten by Celtic in a final until you've beat them in a final. So now I've suffered both deaths and suffered both ways of living. And it's a great excitement. And I have no visions this moment at the treble. I just want to get this team on the winning reign. We're still in the League Cup. We're obviously leading the league, so let's keep it that way for a few weeks. Yeah.
His way inside, there's McCoist! Ali McCoist! The celebrations begin for Rangers. 34 minutes of the match gone. Rangers on the receiving end for so long, and this was down to the creative play of Hugon at right back, coming inside. The first time shot from McCoist, no chance for Bonner, and Rangers go ahead.
Well, McStay, away from McKinnon.
Bonner sliding in a good ball.
The final whistle goes. Rangers the winners by one goal to nil.
Lafferty!
The perfect strike!
Well, somehow or other, Bones wasn't in position. Oh, that's another booking. This is the fifth booking. And you know, it really is now getting out of hand. It
has been reckless.
Off. Burns is off for that tackle. And up he goes. And that's a goal. McLeish. Well, now it's really getting out of hand. And the referee could quite easily book Patterson again. And Patterson's already been booked. If this is the case, Rangers will be down to 9 men. And Patterson goes off. Rangers are now 9 men. And it goes to Black. There's no cover in there. That must be off the bar. Stark goes in and nails number two. And as McCoy goes away, he's offside. And there's an invasion of the pitch. Children are coming onto the pitch who don't really need to. I don't know really what's sparked that off. They might have pulled somebody out, but the game will be. Is McKimmy going to have a go? And the other one, and that is a goal.
Rangers' 1-0 lead from the first leg lasted just 11 minutes. Then a very straightforward cross from Martin was headed in by the unchallenged Ripodas. Patterson and McPherson, two big men, we're left to ask why the neither rose to head the ball away. It stayed at 1-1 on aggregate until 5 minutes before half-time, when Rangers' failure to get hold of the ball eventually allowed Martin to knock them out at 2-1 with arrogant ease. UEFA's observer presumably noted the celebrations.
Wanted from him. Cooper finds McCoist onside. Chance for Rangers. Brilliantly finished. A superb piece of striking by Ali McCoist. His fifth goal of the season. 24 minutes into the first half. Rangers still favouring the in-swinger, Ian Durant taking it. Touched on by McPherson. And McCoist gets his second. For the 34th minute of the match, Ali McCoist gets his second. And to Russell, but preferring the in-swinger once again. There's McPherson. And once again, the corner kick pays off for Rangers.
Can be a very, very dangerous striker of the ball indeed. Still, 33 minutes. The magic left foot of Davy Cooper brings the game to life. Hibs pay a severe penalty for the free kick. 20 yards out, top corner, bang.
Here's Bannon. 1-0. That's a better pass. Now Cooper has it. Might be able to do something here. Through the middle that goes. Here's McCoist. And he's going to score. He has. That's a beautiful goal by McCoist. Oh, yes. Cool as you like. That did require a cool head. Look at it, goalkeeper narrowing the angle. And that lovely chip over.
The Rangers. Just 3 weeks ago, they were riding high at the top of the Premier League. But a succession of defeats has seen them lose their place at the top of the league to Celtic and go out of Europe and the Scull Cup. After the 90-minute session behind closed doors, Chairman John Paton acknowledged there had been strong criticism of the team performance.
The shareholders weren't too happy about the performance of the team. We let them know that the board weren't 100% either. It's a case that we've got to go and try and get new players to strengthen the team. We're not that far away, but we're still not 100%.
Is there money there for new players?
Yes, there's money there for new players.
How many new players do you know?
That's Mr. Wallace's decision. We don't involve ourselves in that. He's the man that says what players he wants and how much he wants to offer for them.
How much criticism was there of Mr. Wallace?
There was some slight criticism. After all, the man's only been here 2 years, and he said it would take 3 years. So we've got to give him that time.
Rangers fans are obviously hungry for success.
Yes, same as the board, that. Same as the board.
If this meeting had been held 3 weeks ago, I suppose it would have been a different picture.
Everybody would have been delighted, but even then, there were hints that the team wasn't as strong as it should be.
And set the record straight.
That was hitting the head once again, that we have no discrimination policy at Ibrox.
As he left the meeting, manager Jock Wallace refused to comment on the criticisms of his team.
At the crossroads. On the playing front, the season is already virtually over for the Light Blues. Defeats by Hearts in the Scottish Cup and by lowly Motherwell at Fir Park last Saturday have left the Ibrox side languishing amongst the also-rans in the race for Scottish football's major honours. Rangers are a club who are used to being winners, and the lack of success has prompted a crisis at the club. Lawrence Marlborough, who lives in California, is the power behind Rangers in 1986. And yesterday, when three directors of the board quit, a power battle had obviously rocked the Ibrox boardroom. However, boardroom changes are far from being at the forefront of the minds of the legions of Rangers supporters. Quite simply, they demand success on the playing field. And the poor playing performances have fueled speculation on the immediate future of Rangers manager Jock Wallace and his backroom staff. Speculation is the key word at Ibrox these days, with rumour and counter-rumour fueling the belief that yesterday's events are merely the tip of the iceberg. For instance, there are strong rumours tonight that former manager John Gregg has been asked to return to Ibrox. But a short time ago, he told us he had not been approached, and after being connected with the club for 25 years, he wouldn't comment on speculation.
Beyond any shadow of a doubt, it's the best club game in the world. It's not a town's divided, it's a country's divided.
It's an important game for both clubs. Celtic are still chasing the Premier League title, though more in hope than optimism. For Rangers, the immediate priority is to salvage the last lucrative Scottish place in Europe. Every seat in Ibrox Stadium is filled. Whatever their form, Celtic and Rangers are still number one at the box office, and they still provide that magic ingredient.
What's special about a Celtic Rangers game?
The atmosphere.
It's a game, but to other folk, it's 90 minutes of pure bigotry. It's kind of religion right through it.
It seems to be Celtic. Why particularly the Celtic?
Just a tradition.
I'm used to listening to the radio or anything. You have to come to a game like this to enjoy it.
There's always been a great respect between the people at Rangers and Celtic. You know, first team level, reserve team level, youth team level, we all want to be each other. But in the aftermath of it all, I wonder how he's feeling.
Yeah.
You only notice the rain if you're locked outside. The choirs are in full cry. The polarization is complete.
Swinging cross, Cammy Fraser! Brilliant goal from Rangers. Cammy Fraser gets his first goal of the season. 10 minutes to half-time and Rangers are right back in the match. Beautifully created by Rangers. Durant
Johnston for Celtic. That's a fine pass to Burns, a great chance for Celtic for the third. Bounce the ball, beating Grant. Here's McCoist. Magnificent goal, Ali McCoist. Scotland's top goal scorer. And a perfect example of how he's achieved that. The Rangers building it up patiently now from the back. McPherson to McKinnon. Russell hugging the right touchline. There's Burns in his new role in midfield. Fine pass to McPherson. Another McLeod back with him. Lower flick. That's the third. The Celtic defence was at sixes and sevens. And Fleck catches him. Well taken by Bonner. Played back in and under the crossbar. Touched in by Tammy Fraser. But it was Dave McKinnon's header initially. McLeod! Good turn by Fleck. He's left O'Leary for dead. Robin McLeod getting back. It's still Fleck. Black. That's for John Robertson, a great chance for Hearts. The opening goal. So it's Robertson against Walker. Penalty kick to Rangers. Oh, McCoist himself will take it. Rangers top scorer. He's missed one this season so far. McCoist. Rangers are back in the match. 22 minutes into the second half. And Ali McCoist, the top scorer, brings them right back to life again. He was the man fouled. He was the man who... The clearance ball missed by Munro. Back to Robertson. The chance for Sandy Clark.
The Rangers Football Club announced that Mr. John Wallace has, by mutual agreement, left the club with effect from today. The Rangers Football Club confirm that they have entered into negotiations with Sampdoria FC for the transfer of Graeme Souness. Mr. Souness is to be invited to join the club as player manager.
News in April 1986 burst on an unsuspecting Scottish public like a bombshell. He might have looked casual as he arrived, but it was a big gamble for himself and the new chairman, David Holmes.
So, gentlemen, could I just say to you, welcome our new player manager, Graeme Souness. Welcome to Cottingham.
He was back to confront one of the biggest challenges in British football. A sleeping giant was about to be aroused.
24 hours later, the new player manager pulled on the Rangers' light blue. But why him?
Well, I penciled in where I wanted the club to go after having been asked to come onto the board. Then the only name I could get into my mind was Graeme Souness, because I felt that if this club were going to be ambitious, then you've got to go for the very best, and I think Graeme is the very best.
And you've done it. You must be a happy man today.
I'm absolutely delighted. I've got a lemon in my pocket here. I suck it every now and again, and keeps the smile off my face.
Since this job was offered to me, I've thought a great deal about who I'd like here and who I'd like with me and who, as far as on the playing staff as well. I mean, to be fair to them, I'm not going to say there has to be wholesale changes here because I haven't seen them play in a long, long time. I have my ideas and hopefully along with the board, we can come to some sort of agreement on both coaching and playing in the near future. But certainly, there has to be changes. I think everybody, supporters alike, realise that.
Critical of the players here, Kenny was going into the finished article, or nearly the finished article. I've got changes to make here.
Well, you have major problems in this sense, that there's a huge population of Rangers supporters looking to you now, like a kind of Moses to lead them from the wilderness.
Yeah, this is something. I mean, I'm not stepping into this job blind. I know what's involved. I know the passion and the feeling there is for Rangers Football Club in Scotland. It's going to take time. I know this is an old cliche about when managers get the job, it's going to take time. I'm not putting any amount of time on when I say we're going to win something. I know that immediately we've got to improve things. And again, I'm not being critical of the people who are here before, but I know immediately I've got to improve things. And start next season, hopefully we will.
Now, I take it, Graham, that there will be no inhibitions placed on you whatsoever as to whom you would sign for this club.
None whatsoever. I don't see that as a problem. I as it's been made public today, I married a Catholic. That wasn't a problem to me. And I'm sure...
Well, let me get this clear now. Let me get it clear without pressurising you at all. A lot of people are interested in this. Mm. It means that you will no longer carry on a policy of finding out which school a boy went to or whatever when he's going to play here.
I mean, at the end of the day, if people are Rangers supporters, they want Rangers to win every game they play in. Now, who does it matter who's playing for Rangers? That's the way I see it. And that's the way I've taken the job. I wouldn't have taken the job under any other circumstances. I'd like that to be known.